An important part of manatee research involves determining animal movements and critical habitat, as well as looking at migration routes. One way researchers monitor manatees is by using satellite tracking devices. A manatee tracking device contains three main parts. First, there's a belt that wraps around the base of the manatee's tail. Attached to the belt is a tether, and floating at the surface is the actual device that contains the monitoring equipment. The best way that scientists have figured out how to attach a manatee tag is by using a belt around the base of the tail, which is also known as the peduncle. And so the belt is attached, and then the rest of the equipment, like the tether and the tag, are floating closer to the surface. The tags are GPS linked tags, and it tracks the manatee's movement, sends the information up to a satellite in space, and then back to a computer for data collection and tracking movements over time. So the tether has a quick release where it attaches to the belt. So if that device in any way gets entangled, it has a quick release mechanism so that the manatee cannot be entangled or trapped or put in danger in any way. Manatees have been tagged for a variety of reasons over the years. In some instances, it's helped inform research. For example, in Tampa Bay, there were studies back in the early 2000s that helped show scientists that manatees would actually go out and forage at night when there was less boat traffic. That's not the same behavior that we see in all parts of the state, so that was a really interesting finding. Naive manatees that either are brought in as orphan calves or otherwise very young manatees that may not have sufficient wild experience at finding fresh water, food supply, or warm water in the winter are tagged as part of our manatee rescue and rehabilitation program, of which Save the Manatee Club is a partner. And by putting tags on these less experienced manatees, it helps ensure their success because their movements can be monitored and veterinarians and biologists can intervene if the manatee seems to not be adapting properly to life in the wild or making some less than ideal choices. We have many manatee success stories thanks in part to the tagging and tracking program, and a few of those manatees actually spend time at Blue Spring, where so many of our adoptees are. One of them is an adoptee, Annie. Annie was a young calf when she was rescued, and there's another calf, Rocket, that was also rescued at a similar time, and so they were both tagged and released at the same time, kind of to pal around, and they both continue to come back to Blue Spring. Annie has given birth to multiple calves, so she is 100% a success story. We've learned a great deal about manatees and how they use habitat and move around the southeastern United States and beyond because of these tracking studies. Some manatees that winter in Crystal River actually spend their summers all the way in Alabama. We've seen manatees that travel the length of Florida's peninsula. So we've come to know a great deal about how manatees move, including outside of Florida. So we've had manatees that have been tagged and gone from Florida to the Bahamas, or manatees that have been captured in the springtime up in Georgia, and we've found how they make their way back to Florida and the habitat that they use once they get here. Alligators typically don't pose any sort of a threat to manatees, but there have been cases of a manatee tag being recovered with alligator bite marks in it. It's hard to know exactly what happened, but you can maybe imagine a scenario where a manatee is swimming by an alligator and the tag canister maybe bumps the alligator, spooks it. Maybe alligators are just as curious as manatees can be. If citizens see a tagged manatee, the best thing to do is to report it. Sometimes tags can be damaged or the batteries die, and researchers might be trying to find that individual manatee. And you can report those tags to the same number that you would report injured manatees or speed zone violations. So that's 1-888-404-3922. Another good idea is to take a photo of the tag, because that can also help the researcher determine whose manatee it is, who owns the tag, and if it's one that they've been having trouble finding. So if you do have a photo, you can text or email that photo along with the information about where and when you saw the manatee to tip@myfwc.com.